Today we have the all-new 2021 Toyota Venza, and this is Toyota's new two-row SUV. We're gonna go through a full look at everything on the exterior, the interior, take it for a test drive, and I'm gonna talk about what's on different trim levels, just so you know. Now first, I kinda wanna clear this up a little bit. What exactly is the Venza? Where did the Venza come from? Well, Toyota was making the Venza a few years ago, and then they stopped, and it was a two-row SUV that fit between the RAV4 and the Highlander, and that's exactly what this one is. They just brought it back, but now it's hybridized, and I'll tell you all about that. Let's get started. All right, everyone, let's take a look at these exterior details. So before I start that off, if you have already subscribed, thank you so much. If you haven't, please go down below, subscribe, click the bell so you don't miss any more reviews on all types of different vehicles. Now the Venza comes in three trim levels, the LE, XLE, and Limited, which is what we have here. You're not gonna find the XSE style type of Toyotas like you see on other models, but starting up front, you got this in-your-face type of front end. So typical large grille from Toyota, kind of a pointy nose, I guess you could say. And one way that you know for sure it's a hybrid is that blue area around the Toyota emblem. And then check this out, you've got standard headlights, LED headlights, standard LED daytime running lights, but this double daytime running light that's acting as the blinker is only on the XLE and Limited. And the XLE and Limited actually give you better LED headlights as far as ratings go and type of headlight compared to the LE trim. You will not find fog lights here. You see those little black circles on the bottom? Those could be fog lights. I wonder if Toyota's gonna add them sometime, but you don't have fog lights on this trim. And you actually get a little bit of an air curtain right there. There is some air that actually passes through there to help with aerodynamics. Now, if you want to see how well these headlights do at night, I have a night video showing that off, so be sure to check that out. The only thing is you don't get adaptive headlights like you'll find on the RAV4. Now, this Venza color is Coastal Gray Metallic. It's a pretty simple gray color. It has a little bit of bluish tint to it and some metallic-y flake. What do y'all think of the color and the styling of this new Venza? Now, the wheels are gonna vary a little bit depending on the trim. So you'll get 18-inch wheels on the LE and 19-inch wheels on the rest of them, which is what we have right here. Has a lot of spokes on it, which is kind of a more premium and luxurious look. So what do you think of that? You get this hybrid badge on the side, so you do let people know that it is a hybrid. There's not a big indicator otherwise. You have blinkers in the mirror on every single mirror. Every mirror is also heated. They have blind spot monitoring in them. They're power folding, and the Limited model actually gets puddle lights, which I'll show you in a little bit. Dimensionally, this is 186.6 inches long, which is about 5 to 6 inches longer than the Toyota RAV4, even though it has the same wheelbase. The Venza also gives you 7.7 inches of ground clearance and an independent suspension, so it should ride and handle well, which we'll talk about in a little bit. Now, as they come around to the back, you have a very sloped rear end, kind of a really unique design. You have a really large taillight up there. Look at that, really long and wide. You even have this really large, wide LED light bar. Have our blinker down here, which is an LED blinker. I don't like the fact that the blinker is low and small, but at least it is LED. And even though it's a hybrid, you get a double tipped exhaust outlet down below. Here's something that really surprised me getting to the cargo area. The fact that this hands-free liftgate is standard on every single trim, even the base LE model. So if that's something that you've been hunting for and you don't want to pay extra on other vehicles, you don't have to pay extra with the Venza. This is also height adjustable. You can program how high it goes up at the front, and there's a button to lower it and a button to lock it and lower it too. So that's nice.
Now, as we take a look at the rest of this cargo area, it is not tiny, but the biggest factor is that the sloping roof definitely cuts into the cargo area's height availability. But I mean, you have decent width, you have decent depth right here. You can shove several carry-on suitcases back here and bigger suitcases and be okay. You have that tonneau cover available that comes across. You also have a light, an LED light right over there. My one complaint is that there's no hook, like grocery bag hook or tie down on either side. Usually there's like a fold out hook or at least like a hook for a net. There's none of that. So, I mean, I wish there was something to tie something down back here or at least hook something up. But underneath of here, you get a spare tire and a pretty large area. So this would be a good area for some jumper cables or things like that. And the fact that you get a spare tire standard on every trim, even though it's a hybrid, is fantastic. And then in order to fold those seats down, the second row seats, you have to go to the second row or reach ahead. There's no lever or power folding function. This is not typical in a non-luxury brand, but considering this is more premium, I'd maybe expect that. And this is decent size. You can fit some good stuff back here. There's just a little bit of a hump and a ramp going onto those seats.
And when you're all done back here, you don't even have to push the button. If you've got your hands full, just stick your foot up under there again and it'll close for you. So that's kind of a nice feature too. Now, when we look under the hood powering this Venza, there's one thing that you really need to know is that the only way to get a Venza is as a hybrid. So if you want a regular engine, naturally aspirated engine, no electric component, no hybrid component, you can't get it. It's only with this hybrid setup, which in my opinion, I wish that they gave us another option, but this hybrid system is very efficient. It's got a 2.5 liter four cylinder engine that has direct and port injection, plus three electric motors and a lithium ion battery, instead of Toyota's usual nickel metal hydride battery, like the RAV4. This still gives us the same 219 horsepower, same as the RAV4, and with its electronically controlled CVT transmission. And just like the RAV4, this hybrid system comes standard with all-wheel drive. So that's another thing. The Venza only comes in all-wheel drive and only as a hybrid. No front-wheel drive option, no non-hybrid option. Now, the biggest plus side to a hybrid is that this one, you don't plug in. It's completely self-sufficient. It will charge itself, take care of itself, do everything on its own without you having to do anything. And you'll get 40 miles per gallon in the city and 37 miles per gallon on the highway. So those numbers are very good, just a tad bit lower than the RAV4. And in my highway miles per gallon test, ranging from 70 to about 60 miles an hour, we got about 39 miles per gallon. And if you're a little bit weary about getting a hybrid, Toyota's hybrid component warranty, any of the hybrid components is covered for 8 years or 100,000 miles, and the actual battery, the lithium ion battery, is 10 years, 150,000 miles.
Now, the Venza gives you the smart key system standard. You've got a little bit of a different key fob than most of the other new Toyotas. It's a little bit more substantial, has a little bit of a nicer feel to it. You can three press the lock button to remote start it, but as soon as you open the door, that remote start will shut off. And we have the same typical Toyota sensor here, so you can push that to lock it, and then the mirrors will fold, or you can put your hand back there and there's a sensor to unlock it. That's on every trim. But the XLE and Limited let you do that on the rear doors too. So you can lock and unlock with the rear doors touch sensor. And the Limited trim actually gives you a puddle lamp from the mirror that says Venza on the ground, and you'll get illuminated door sills.
Now, as we hop inside the Venza, one nice thing is that it's got really easy ingress and egress. So if you have mobility issues, you're set. Plus, on the top two trims, you get the entry exit system where the seat and the steering wheel will move to your preferred position. So each trim level gets a little bit of different variation with the seats. On the base LE model, you're gonna get 8-way power adjustable seats that are cloth, no heating, no ventilation, no memory settings. Those will still give you adjustable lumbar support. On the XLE, the second trim, those seats are now gonna be heated and they're gonna have a little bit of this Softex synthetic leather trim on them as well. But then when you get to the Limited, which we have here, you're gonna get heated, ventilated seats that are Softex material, including 4-way lumbar support. The Softex is a synthetic leather, and these seats are actually pretty soft. They have perforations in them and a moderate amount of bolstering, and they're just really comfortable in general. I've had no complaints with these seats. They almost seem a little bit softer than maybe the Camry seats. I remember it to be a little bit firm, but they're comfortable. I've had no complaints in here thus far. And the steering wheel is leather wrapped on every trim. On our Limited trim, a heated steering wheel is standard, which is nice, but I do have one complaint with that. And you can get this heated steering wheel optional on the XLE. But as you see, it is power adjustable as well. Up and down, in and out. And space-wise, this center console is pretty wide, so knee space isn't that wide or that big, but otherwise it's a pretty comfortable place to be. And overall, the Venza interior is very nice. It still has a typical Toyota look, but it's got a lot of nice materials, good look to some of the materials, and it just has a more premium feel in general.
Now that we're inside, push button start, foot on the brake. And a lot of times in a hybrid, the engine doesn't actually start up. It will just say, on the left there, it says ready. That means that the engine is on.
Now let me run through all of the interior features. So you have a nice material here. This whole thing is really soft. Even up here, super soft. I'm really impressed by that. A nice silver aluminum door handle, and even this wood look, or this wood grain look trim that runs over here. You got all automatic one-touch windows, power folding mirrors, memory settings on the door, and space for a bottle down here and a little bit of extra storage. Just to the inside, you'll see all these controls from your display brightness, your camera, heated steering wheel, etc. And in front of us, Toyota gives us a leather-wrapped steering wheel standard, like I said. A heated steering wheel is standard on our Limited and optional on the XLE. It's a very soft material. It's got nice grips on here. And this is Toyota's newest steering wheel design. So you've got some controls on the left, some controls on the right, including your lane keeping system, radar cruise control. You don't have the cruise control stock like you did in old Toyotas, but I like the way that this steering wheel feels. You also have automatic rain sensing windshield wipers, optional on the Limited trim, only on the Limited trim. And right in front of us is where things will change a little bit. The base LE is just gonna give you regular gauges and a 4.2 inch display, but we have this 7-inch display on the XLE and Limited. You still get some physical gauges on the side, but that inside area is 7 inches, and it gives you a good amount of information. You use your steering wheel to scroll through everything, so you can see all of your driving support, like your lane keeping system, radar cruise, all in one spot, audio. You can see how all of your systems are working and that they're on. You can adjust all the system settings. You have Toyota Safety Sense 2.0 on here. So you've got radar cruise, lane keeping system, emergency braking, all that good stuff on here. And we have a trip computer. So don't mind the MPGs. I have been sitting here with it idling because it's been cold right now, or chilly this morning, but there's a good amount of information you can see on here. This isn't my favorite display screen, but it does give you a lot of nice information. And then right up above, you get a head-up display that is optional only on the Limited trim, but it gives you a lot of good information as well, and it's quite large. As we take a broader look at the interior, the entire dash and these panels and even all along the doors here, everything is soft touch. But you get a different screen here than you do in most Toyotas. So this is a 12.3 inch screen, but you will get an 8-inch screen standard on the top, on the LE and XLE, which will give you Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, and Sirius XM standard. But this 12.3 inch screen is standard on the Limited and optional on the XLE. So as you can see in our screen right now, we have a few different things showing up here. So first of all, you can customize your home screen. You can dictate what you see. If I go to audio down below, you'll still have information over here. Like, I kind of keep this right there so that I can keep track of how the hybrid system's working. It's kind of fun to watch. You can open that whole screen up, as you can see. You can even see climate controls on here, your heated seat controls, and then back to that. And there's just a lot of different stuff that you can look at if you want to. Personally, I wish we could have, you know, one thing take up the whole screen, but like if it just moves it around. So that's a little bit annoying. Apple CarPlay doesn't take up the whole screen either. It would be nice to see that. So I don't know if this 12.3 inch screen is worth it for some people, but it works just fine. It's got Toyota's Entune system, which isn't the best. I don't know if this screen is worth the upgrade for some of you. I'd love to hear about that. Toyota's Entune system is starting to feel a little bit more and more dated compared to some of the newer systems. So I'd like to see that upgraded. But there's a lot that you can still customize on here, a lot that you can do. We also have the JBL audio system, which comes with this 12.3 inch screen. It's a 1200 watt 9-speaker system. And check this out, we have the bird's eye view camera, which is only on the Limited trim. So you can access this by going into reverse or pushing the camera button left of the steering wheel. Look at that, it looks around the car, over top the car. So when you're parking, that's really nice. Get another view right here. So you can really see quite well. You can have this automatically come on at low speeds or just when you go into reverse. So you've got that over there. It'll give you dynamic lines when you turn the wheel. You can have a different view, a wider view, or a narrow view. So just a nice camera from Toyota. And when you have this, you also get a camera washer. So that is pretty cool. Now, as we move down, we've got these air conditioning vents, and they might not look like there's anything special about the air conditioning vents, but this has what's called S-flow, to where the climate control system will only direct air where people are occupying seats. So it's a very fast heating and cooling system. Down here is where I have my biggest complaints by far with this interior. Everything that you see here is touch. It's capacitive touch. The volume is touch, which is just not a good idea. I thought people learned from Honda with the no volume knob, but I wish we had a volume knob. I wish we had a tuning knob. Everything is touch. So, I mean, you can't just like, boom, quickly turn it off or turn it down. You have to touch, 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 which gets kind of annoying. And the dual zone climate control that you'll see here for you and your passenger, the controls are easily laid out and nice. That's standard on every trim. But this touch sensitive type of climate control is actually only on the limited trim standard and optional on the XLE. I just want regular buttons. I don't know about you, but at least you do have some shortcuts for your audio system up there. But this is the weakness for me. Piano black, shiny black, collects lint, fingerprints, gets scratches very easily, and I don't like having to touch sensitive everything. All right, enough with the ranting. So you've got your start button right here, which kind of takes up a lot of space right here. I wish that this was maybe integrated in up here or something, because it just takes up a lot of space. But you've got a couple USB ports, you've got an auxiliary port down there, and this is actually a wireless charging pad. You could also just use it as a little storage area. You also get electronic parking brake, brake hold, EV mode, which we'll go through in the test drive, and then your drive modes for sport, normal, or eco. And you've got that wood grain look on the inside of there as well. That's on everything except the base LE trim. And then you've got a nice material coming back through here as well. This looks nice. I like the color. You have some stitching here. This just looks good overall. I like the shifter as well. Everything looks and feels nice. Now the cup holders are actually a little more interesting than they look. So if I don't put an insert in there, my bottle wiggles around like crazy because there's actually a rim inside of there. But Toyota gives you the little inserts like I have over here. So you can have shorter drinks, you can have taller drinks, you can take the inserts out or have two inserts in there. So that's kind of cool that Toyota gives you that option to have different type drinks in there. Now this armrest is nice and soft as well, and there's a cool thing about it. You can slide it back to expose your heated and ventilated seats. So for you and your passenger, those are there. Lift this up, and then right there, this little tray is a little storage tray, and it's also where you can store the little cup inserts. I wish that this could like lift up with the armrest sometimes, but it doesn't, but it gives you a nice wide opening. And there is a 12 volt power outlet in there. Now up here is where things change a little bit. The base LE gives you just a regular manual flipping mirror. The XLE will give you an automatic dimming rearview mirror. And then our limited will give us an automatic dimming rearview mirror with a camera. So you can have this digital camera on there. So that's literally a camera looking out the back of the vehicle. You even have garage controls over here. You can customize how bright it is. How wide it is, whether it's up or down and zoomed in, and you can really spy on people behind you picking your nose with that thing. And one little complaint is that Toyota is still using these little extensions off of its visors instead of the actual visor moving. I'd love to hear what y'all think about that and which one you prefer. But up above, check this out. Open that up again. Okay, so look at that. You've got a panoramic roof. And this doesn't actually open up the glass. It's a fixed panoramic roof. It's called the Stargaze panoramic roof. This is optional only on the limited trim. And right now you can look and it's actually, you see the sun back there, that little dot? It's actually like frosted over. It's blocking light. But check that out. You can press a button and then it exposes it. So you can let in more light or block out some light. And at night, it looks pretty cool as well, depending on which way you have it. The way you do that is just with this button right here. So it's technically an electrochromatic or electrochromic type of roof. So you can see there's not much light in there. Now there's quite a bit of light coming in. So that's pretty cool. I really like that option. And at night, there is some ambient lighting in a couple of different areas. Although it is very gentle, it is welcome. It gives you a nice ambiance at nighttime. Now let's take a quick look at the visibility. Looking out the back, that third window does a decent job of actually letting you see some vehicles, but I'll let you be the judge. Now the back seat of the Venza is not a bad place to be, but compared to some other two rows, it's not quite as spacious as you would expect. This has the same wheelbase as the RAV4 and virtually the exact same, like a tenth of an inch difference in combined legroom. So the back seat is still good and spacious, but I would expect it to be a little bit bigger, but this is still good enough for most people. Back here, you've got the same Softex material seats. They're still perforated, even though they're not ventilated back here, but you've got this folding armrest, couple of cup holders. This is nice and soft. The door materials over here are nice and soft. The armrests still have the same quality materials on them. These seats don't slide forward and backwards, but they can recline a little bit. And the battery pack is actually underneath of these seats. So that may be one reason that they don't slide forward and backwards. For your backseat comfort, you have air conditioning vents right in front of you and a couple of fast charging USB ports right below that. But to my surprise, even at this price point and this limited trim, we don't have heated seats back here. That's a little bit surprising. All right, so to start this Venza up on this test drive, push button start, foot on the brake, and it's just gonna be really quiet most of the time because the engine doesn't usually need to run. To start it off, I have it in EV mode. And in EV mode, the gas engine is off. And it'll tell you up there whether or not you are in EV mode. And you're limited to a certain amount of throttle pressure and a certain speed too. The car can put itself in EV mode and shut the engine off at higher speeds, but you cannot stay in the dedicated EV mode at low speeds. But if you're going through parking lots or drive-through or something to where, you know, you don't need to really get on it and accelerate and don't want to use any gas, you can put it in EV mode and just cruise around at low speeds. I think it's like 24 miles an hour or something like that that you can go up to. Now, I'm going to take it out of EV. Well, actually, I'm going to leave it in EV mode and I'm just going to accelerate and you'll get to see how fast we can go. And I'll let you know when the gas comes on. Still in EV mode up to, all right, it said EV mode deactivated. The accelerator was pressed too far. Now in this test drive, I'm going to tell you about my first impressions, ride comfort, handling, what it's like to drive this hybrid in particular. And my first impression is that the Venza is a quieter and more relaxed version of the RAV4. It's comfortable. It's about the same efficiency. It's got the same wheelbase, so basically the same structure as the RAV4, but Toyota made some noticeable changes, and they wrote about this in their press release too, about using sound absorbing materials. So that's really nice to hear and to see, because it's evident in how quiet this is. We're about to get on a rougher textured road, and we're doing this a little bit backwards as opposed to how I usually do it, but we're on a road surface with rocks on it. It's usually louder, picks up a lot more road noise. And the Venza is still pretty quiet. I'm sure you can hear some of that, but my decibel ratings on here and on the interstate scored really well. Definitely better than they did on the RAV4 hybrid. One disappointing thing though is that this glass is not laminated, it's just your regular glass. I'm guessing they're saving that for the next Lexus NX, which will be similar to this. All right, so as I'm coasting to a stop right here, I'm braking, and it will tell you down there, it's got that almost like a tachometer for hybrids, a charge section, an eco section, and a power section. And when it's in the charge section, your regenerative brakes are helping to recharge your battery. Now we are just in normal mode. I'm gonna go ahead and put the pedal down. Go, and you kind of just have one constant drone coming out of here. This has the hybrid system continuous variable transmission. It's not the same as a real physical belt and pulley, chain pulley type of mechanism with a regular CVT, but it operates the same, and for the most part it's completely unnoticeable and unintrusive, and it just works well with this hybrid for the best efficiency. Now, ride comfort in the Venza is very good. This road is mostly smooth, but there are some broken pieces of pavement sometimes and some bumps, and it soaks up potholes really well, train tracks really well, everything like that. And I think part of that is because we don't have huge wheels that give us a stiff, harsh ride. You're gonna be happy with the ride in the Venza. Now we're just kind of cruising in some traffic right here. I just reset the miles per gallon and it's varied quite a bit in my time in here. It did good on my highway trip. It's done good in town sometimes, but other times it just hasn't done as well. And it's been a little chillier than usual, so the gas engine has had to run more frequently, but we are actually coasting along in EV mode. The car has itself in EV mode, so we're not using any gas at all right now. And I'm just cruising along behind these people. If I was going to pass and accelerate, then the gas engine would turn on. But just in normal mode, it's in EV mode by itself. So you can really pay attention to when the car is in EV mode or when you're actually using the gas engine. You can watch it down here. You can watch it on this main screen. For example, I just put that on the screen to where you can kind of see all that information. I know you probably can't really see it right now, but one thing about hybrids is that the brakes can be a little bit weird. They have regenerative brakes to where a portion of your braking actually helps to recharge your battery. But then you still get into the real physical brakes, and the transition between the two can be a little bit jarring and a little bit jerky, but it's pretty good on this Toyota hybrid. Now, most of you probably won't use it and don't need to, but I just put us in sport mode. And the thing about sport mode is that we have electric power and regular gas power. Whoa. And now getting on the brakes a little more. So there's a transition point from regular brakes, or the regenerative brakes, to the regular brakes. It's a little bit jerky, but not bad. But anyways, this is quicker acceleration-wise than you probably would expect. It's not a burner, but with the electric power, the electric torque, it happens instantly. And then you have the regular gas engine that still gives you some torque and some power. Now, I just totally dropped our miles per gallon on here, but handling in the Venza is certainly not a strong point, but it is more than sufficient, especially for most of you that are going to be looking at buying this. The weight of the steering wheel is a medium. It's not heavy. It's not hard to steer around. It's not hard to park, especially with the 360 camera that you'll get on there. So not bad at all. And this does have Toyota Safety Sense 2.0, not the 2.5, but it does give us radar cruise control with the vehicle in front of us. It gives us the lane keeping system. It can do the lane centering technology as well. And keeping it under cruise, going through there, it holds its own. It does just fine. I just turned the lane centering on. And one thing I've noticed about Toyota is that it can kind of ping pong you back and forth a little more than I like, or almost fight with you a little more. But right now, just on this straightaway, it's doing pretty well. I usually turn the lane centering off, but if you want to see a more detailed demonstration of this, I have a video of it with Lexus's safety system, which is basically the same, in the description box below this video. To give you a quick recap of the Venza, driving it day to day is nice. I mean, the materials in here are nice. It's a very comfortable ride. It's a quiet ride. You have good cameras, like you have this camera up here. You've got the 360 camera. And the hybrid system is very smooth. It's self-sufficient. It pretty much does everything on its own. But you can kind of baby the hybrid system a little bit and watch when the gas engine's on, when you're using electric power and all of that. But let's go ahead and wrap things up on this 2021 Venza.
So as we wrap things up on this 2021 Toyota Venza, it definitely is a more premium version of the RAV4, and it's honestly really Lexus-like. Now with this Venza, you're gonna give up a little bit of practicality. You're not gonna have any extra space compared to the RAV4, but you're actually gonna have less space, but you're gonna have a nicer, quieter, and more comfortable interior overall. This Venza is also very efficient, so if that's something that you're looking for, comfort and efficiency and some premium touches, this is the Venza for you. Even on that LE trim or the XLE trim, you still get several standard features. So leave your comments down below what you think of this Venza. I'd love to hear about it. Thank you so much for watching. Be sure to subscribe. Hit that thumbs up button if you liked the video. Double tap it twice if you didn't. Have a great rest of your day.